students, when they come to us, they ask whether they can work as an international student in Canada. And the good news is that, yes, students are eligible to work while they are studying. And there are quite a few ways that you can work while you are completing your education. So there is on-campus work, which refers to, you know, the building, as the name suggests, on-campus, when you are working in the building of your university or the college campus. And however, there are some colleges, some schools that have more than one campus. So you have to check with your administration department whether you'd be eligible to work in any of the other campuses. But in all likelihood, it is the campus that you are studying in is where you would be entitled to work. However, if you are working as a teaching or a research assistant and your work relates to a research grant, so you are given a grant and you have to do your research. So, you know, it's not necessary that you're going to get all your materials of research in your university, or if you, it's a hands-on job and you're supposed doing something related to clinical psychology, it has to be affiliated to a hospital and you will have to do your work in the hospital, which is outside your campus. So that way you will be able to go out and work, and that is still a part of your campus work. So apart from that, there are co-op placements and there are internships. Very briefly, as a co-op student, and generally, as I said, international students can work up to 20 hours per week. And you can definitely, during regular school session or while you are studying as a part of an intensive program with no planned breaks, if your studies are part-time because you're finishing the last session of your program, and if you are a graduate student who has finished the required course for your degree. So these are, under these circumstances, you can work as an international student for 20 hours. But at the same time, you can work full-time during your official school breaks. So I do have some companies that I am associated with in Canada. And during summertime, we get a lot of these co-op students who come on board and they work with us. And most of the time, these are paid internships that the company offers. You can work full-time during official school breaks, such as the winter and summer holidays or spring break, or after you have finished your studies and you have applied for a non-student work permit. So these are some of the situations under which you are able to work. So if you have seen my previous slide, there was something called the co-op placements. Now here I'll dive a little deep into the co-op program. So co-op program is something that involves working as a part of your program of study. And you may work on or off campus. So when we are deciding about the shortlisting the course that a student would like to do, we try to get a co-op program whereby the student, while they are finishing off their studies, they are getting every year they get 3 to 4 months to work in the field of the study. So this is a great way to get hands-on proficient experience in Canada. In their Canadian work setting. At the same time, it's a great way to really network with your potential employers. So definitely co-op programs are great programs that students really opt for. Now, when you are a part of the co-op program at a college or university, you can apply for a co-op work permit. But for that, you have to have a valid study permit. The working is integrated into your study program in Canada. So that is something that you really need to look out for. Also, you have a letter from your school saying that it is necessary for the student to work, which is important for him to complete the course. And your co-op program or internship is 50% or less of the total program of studies. Now, there are certain courses in which you will not be eligible to have a co-op option, and you will not get a co-op work permit if you are studying English or French as a second language, or a general interest course, and courses to prepare you for another study program. So if you're doing a foundation course, or if you're doing a bridge course, so you will not be able to work at that point in time. So it's always important that you go ahead and you know, look for programs which have work permit or a co-op program as an eligibility. Again, internships provide you with the on-the-job training, and when you are an intern, you are you know, someone in the workplace supervises you, and working again as an intern, you gain knowledge and skills to help you succeed in the trade or profession. And the work permit that you need to work as an intern is the same that you would require when you are working as a co-op student.